Mississippi Farm Bureau, and welcome the new head basketball coach in Starkville, Chris Jans, named head basketball coach at Mississippi State. Coach, I guess we'll start by saying congratulations, and I feel like this is a question that I've asked of other coaches before. Why this job at this time?
Appreciate it, first of all. Second, I think it's perfect timing for all of us. You know, Mississippi State obviously has got a rich tradition of winning. Although they've only been to one tournament since 2009, I think it's time to have some new energy, a new look. Certainly, you know, we're coming off a pretty good run. Wish we were still playing. But since I started this business, I've always wanted to compete against the best. Coach the best players, play against the best players, and same thing as coaches. And we're going to have that opportunity here. So we're excited to get started. Certainly, we got a lot of work to do, but we're excited to be here.
Coach, I saw that you were out on the football field today with Coach Mike Leach as they start up spring practice here in Starkville. You know, Coach Leach is so readily identified by the style of football that he coaches, the air raid. What is the Chris Jans style of basketball?
First of all, that was on my to-do list when I arrived. I couldn't wait to meet Coach Leach. Certainly just loved him from afar, and I asked AD John Cohen if Mike could just do the press conference. It would be a lot more enjoyable probably for the fans, but they were stuck with me. So that was a treat to be out there, and can't wait to watch his teams compete at the gridiron this year. But, you know, I think hopefully, you know, people will – identify us with just our compete level. It's a big thing for me. You know, we work so hard at this. It's so meaningful. You put so much time into preparing for these games. Why wouldn't you leave everything on the court? It makes no sense. We only get, you know, 30, 35 opportunities throughout the year to show everybody how hard we're working, show everybody how much this means to us. So I want people to identify our passion, our intensity, our focus. I think we're going to be a team that plays for each other and with each other. I like to think that we're going to be an aggressive attacking style on both ends of the floor. We're going to fly around, man. We're going to fly around, and we're going to walk out of the tunnel and home or on a road and expect to win every game. Regardless who, you know, we're playing, regardless of the time of year, our approach is going to be, you know, we're here to compete, here to win, and we're just going to be an attacking team and a confident team at the same time.
Coach, forgive me for backing off of basketball just for a second. I'm curious, what did you and Mike Leach talk about? Because this could have gone anywhere.
Mutual friends.
Okay.
Mutual friends. Got some mutual friends from the stops that he's had, and they've hit him, and they've hit me, and we didn't get to talk probably as long as I'd like to, but you know, it's only the first day of spring practice, so I guess I'll give him a break on that one. But he was great. He was great, and they were organized, and they were off and running. And you know, way back in the day, right? I played football in high school, and you know, so I know enough to be able to be an armchair quarterback for the Mississippi State football team, and I'll be doing that for sure.
You won't be alone in that, I promise, Coach. There'll be a few hundred thousand extras doing that. You said something yesterday at your press conference that really stuck with me, and that was talking about not building a program, but building a team each and every year. You talked about the transfer portal and sort of this new era of college basketball. It seems you're ready to embrace that era. Is that an accurate statement that this new age of college basketball fits what you want to do?
Yeah, absolutely. And if you don't, you're going to get left behind, regardless of how the fans, the media, the coaches, the players, whomever feels about the landscape of college basketball right now. That's where it's at. The days of having, you know, classes stacked upon one another and watching these kids grow into starring roles and doing their time, if you will, until they're more ready to compete, I just don't think you're going to see that very often. And when you do, it's going to be a rare situation. most programs are going to worry about the upcoming season, and that's it. You're not going to try to balance your classes like you used to back in the day. You're just going to field a team, and you're going to do whatever you can to get the best team on the floor for that particular season and worry about the next year when that season's complete. I just think that's – I don't think there's any question unequivocally that's the way it's going to be. And, yeah, I've been doing that for a long, long time, so it's right in my wheelhouse. When other coaches talk about building a program or, you know, want kids to, you know, be here and do all that, like, I just – that's just not going to be the norm. It's just not going to be the norm. And, again, it doesn't matter what your personal opinion is. That's the reality of the business of college basketball right now. That's the landscape of what's going on with the ability to leave and transfer and not sit out. That's just the way it's going to be. You're going to see a lot of kids moving around. You're going to see big classes coming in. And for the fans, you know, some are probably disappointed because, you know, they build relationships with them. They, you know, grow an affinity to, you know, some of the kids that are wearing, you know, the colors of their favorite team. But, you know, you're just not going to see a bunch of 4 and 5 year guys staying at the same place that often.
And another thing you mentioned yesterday, you know, because the portal works both ways, obviously. You can bring guys in, but guys can go out. You were talking about some of your most important recruiting is going to be trying to keep your team that you currently have together. Obviously, Bulldog fans will be keeping an eye on Iverson Molinar and Tolu Smith. As you've met these your team that you have here in Starkville, what's been their reception to your early messages?
They've been great. You know, I mentioned it in the press conference. Gave a shout out to Coach Allen and their staff, and I meant every word that I said. They need to be applauded for the quality of student athlete that is here. I've just been super impressed with their manners, their focus, their relationship, attitude. They've been great. They've listened. They've asked questions. They've been attentive. Just seem like really, really nice young men, and that's a great way to start. I've just been super impressed with a lot of them, and we're continuing to try to build relationships in a short period of time with the young men and obviously the people in their circle as well. I'm not on periphery. I want kids that want to play for me and this university at the same time. Obviously, these kids here didn't sign up for this. It's, you know, it's not their fault. It's a ugly side of college basketball, but it is what it is, and a lot of kids do have to, unfortunately, go through it, and they're going through it right now. So we're just going to try to, like I said, build the relationship in a short order, give them some space, get them to know me, and certainly the other way around, and try to figure it out. But, you know, it's the roster won't look the same next year. I mean, let's just be real and be honest. It's just not. And you know, we'll find out, you know, as time unfolds, you know, who's going to be there and who's not. And certainly we're recruiting new players as we speak.
Chris Jans visiting with us, new head basketball coach at Mississippi State. Coach, I don't mean this disrespectfully to any of the previous coaches, but the reality is Mississippi State basketball, which has a passionate fan base and at one point absolutely filled up Humphrey Coliseum, one of the most difficult places to play in the country, it's gotten stale with the fans in recent years. Obviously, winning brings people to the building. But beyond winning, what do you do to try to kind of rebuild a culture and an excitement among fans around the program?
Well, it starts with me. I've got to engage the community on campus. I've got to engage the Starkville community. I got to engage the Bulldog fans that are all throughout the state and outside the state. You know, I've got to be the face of the program that'll bleed into my staff and my players. And we're going to be active. We're going to be visible. We're going to try to make friends and get people excited about Mississippi State basketball for the upcoming season. And then when we get to the fall and the students are back, you know, I'm going to get out there and be involved and get them fired up. And certainly going to work with the marketing department in terms of trying to help the game day experience as best we can. Because in this day and age, you know, we're fighting for their discretionary time, their discretionary money. And with the TV and the exposure, it's, you know, it's a lot easier to watch your favorite favorite teams now and not have to be in the building. And so we've got to make it where they have such a good time, not just with the fan experience or the game experience, but with our product on the court. You know, I think we got to play a style that, you know, they can relate to, and we'll be a tough, hard-nosed, blue-collar team that leaves everything on the floor. But at the same time, we're gonna get after it. We're gonna be athletic and downhill, and you know, play above the rim and play with fire. Like, I want my kids to play with emotion. Certainly, I want it to be positive, but I want them to show that emotion. I want them to you know, show everybody how they feel about, you know, what they're doing out there. So I think there's a lot of factors that go into it, and we're going to try to make that happen right away.